What's going on, guys? Jeff Pollock back here. Today, we're at the Farm Pond. I come to this one quite a bit because there's really nice cat, bass, and bluegill. But today, we're going to be using the spinning rod. It's an Ugly Stick GX2 with the optics reel. I do believe 10-pound test, and today, we're going to be throwing the Rebel Wee Crawfish. If you can see right there, there's a bunch of pine trees down for a cover for fish. And they're just, they like, and this pond particularly, they like to hang out around the bank because there's a lot of cover trees. So I'm gonna put you on a chest strap. We're gonna see what we can catch. Enjoy. All right, so I'm gonna hit this spot first, and then I'm probably gonna make my way around that way. I did see a fish jump over here, so I'm gonna try to cast as close as I can to them trees right there, and we're gonna see what hits them. Now, yesterday, a buddy and I went to the river, and we waded a little section of it, and they seemed to like this color crawfish. It's just the smaller one, but today I'm using the bigger one. There's a bullfrog underneath the deck. Yum. Look at that. I can't get it close enough to the trees. Where I want to go is right there. That is perfect. So, I'm pretty sure I'm snagged on one of these trees. So, it looks like we're going this way. Let's see if I can get over there. There we go. Never mind. I got her. Well, with me yanking on that, I probably just scared all the fish that were in there. So, we are going to go around this way first. As soon as I get this seaweed off here. I just hooked my freaking shirt. How'd I do that? We're gonna walk around these ducks right here. We're gonna come back up. Thank you. there's a lot of fish that like to hang out in this corner right over here. We are targeting bass today, but I'll go for a bluegill. This Rebel Recraw also has a really good swim action. Oops. Bunch of seaweed. Right here along this bank, a lot of bluegill like to hang in here. Snagged on a tree. There we go. Oh, bullfrog. That scared me as much as I scared him. Whew. I can see a couple bluegill right here down in front of me. I wonder if they'll hit it. Well, I had one hit it, but I didn't set the hook in time. There we go. Got one to hit. Oh, he's peeing on me. That's nice. One thing I do hate about these treble hooks is that it's hard to get out of the fish's mouth without the other side going back in. There we go. Oh, it's peeing on me. See if we can get another one to bite. He probably went back and told all of his friends not to bite my crawfish. Nope, there we go. Ooh, right by the eye. Another beautiful bluegill. I would say that, like I said, there's thousands and thousands of bluegill over on this side. Oh, as soon as that one hit, something hit it. I don't know if you guys seen that or not. It was like as soon as it hit the water, a fish hit it top water. There we go. All I gotta do is just let it sit there and they'll come up and hit it. Had a blue guy there nibble my line. I'm going to move down a little bit. See that? As soon as I threw it out there, he came up and hit it top water. What is that? That looks like a baby bass just swim right in front of me. Man, it could have been more than that long. Oh, something just spurred out up there. See if we can get him. Gonna keep moving a little bit. There's something jumping back down here where we had the bluegill. So I'm gonna go back down here real quick. Not gonna go all the way down there. I'm gonna go right here and throw it where I saw that jump at. Might have been a bluegill.